This documentary explores the epistemological paradigm shift that unleashed an age of reason that hijacked the authority of scripture, made way for the secularization of inquiry and the removal of God's truth from science and the foundations of human knowledge.
Ptolemy, I don't know if we know that he really looked like this, but Ptolemy, you know, was one of the greatest scientists ever and most influential scientists. He sort of codifies the geocentric universe.
The geocentric theory was the first to arrive. The humans believed that they were the center of the entire universe.
Everybody supported it, even the Catholic Church.
And this Earth-centered universe prevailed for centuries until Copernicus and Galileo turned that around. But what I want to call your attention to, Ptolemy, you know, was one of the greatest scientists ever. Notes that he penned in the margin.
I stand in the presence of Zeus himself and take my fill of ambrosia.
Satan comes to kill, steal, and destroy in the form of beer, drugs, and steroids. Now don't think for a second Jesus Christ got drunk. The high priest was not a punk.
So there's something else going on that nobody seems to be talking about. And this is a trend that will continue for thousands of years to follow this. At least 2,000 years to follow this. Galileo, interesting case. Galileo was kind of an exception to this. He was a deeply religious man, and a lot of the trouble he got into was because he was just kind of obnoxious. He could have made nice with the Pope, and he did not. And of course, I'm paraphrasing. I mean,
What is all this astrology business? Astrologers became employed only by the state. In many countries, it became a capital offense for anyone but the official astrologer to read the portents in the skies. Why? Because a good way to overthrow a regime was to predict its downfall.
Let me not seem to have lived in vain. Let me not seem to have lived in vain. And he did not.
I am telling you the truth.
He hath made the earth by his power. He hath established the world by his wisdom. And hath stretched out the heaven by his understanding. When he uttereth his voice, there is a multitude of waters in the heavens, and he causeth the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. He maketh lightnings with rain, and bringeth forth the wind out of his treasures. Every man is brutish by his knowledge. Every founder is confounded by the graven image, for his molten image is falsehood, and there is no breath in them. They are vanity, the work of errors. In the time of their visitation, they shall perish. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you of heavenly things? And no man hath ascended up to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man which is in heaven.